Bom dia everyone! So today we're going to look at the Runcam Tom Pro. I tested this camera and I don't really like the field of view. I find that it's a little too narrow. I thought let's look for a lens mod, and the ones on the videos that I've seen on YouTube, it requires some extensive modification like 3D printing of the new case, or you know, something that requires it being naked without the original Runcam Thumb Pro case. And those videos with the successful lens mod, they don't show you what lens they use. Either that or they don't reply to comments on the videos. So I'm gonna do this video and share with you what works and what doesn't. So let's jump straight in. Here we have the Runcam RC18G lens, and this one's got a wide angle. It's a 1.8mm lens. But the depth of the lens is slightly thicker because it's got this fisheye effect, and compared to the original lens of the Runcam Thumb Pro, which is slightly shallower, you won't be able to fit the ND filters that comes together with the Runcam Thumb Pro. On using the RC18G lens with the original casing, you will find that there will be a kind of a vignette around the lens, and if you add the filters, you could actually see the rings around the ND filters. So this RC18G won't really work unless it's a naked Runcam Thumb Pro. So I thought that the Cadex Total V2 had a really nice lens. I used to use this on my micros, so I decided to pull the lens out and test that and see if it works. Do remember that there is another Cadex Total which has the plastic lens that won't work so well. This is also a 1.8mm lens, and this will work much better on the Thumb Pro. So opening up the Runcam Thumb Pro, it's an easy job. We're just removing three screws. You gotta open the SD card slot case first. There will be one screw over here. Next, we remove these two screws and take out the back plate. And you can just slide the camera out. And from there, what you're gonna do is you're gonna run your X-Acto knife along the lens, as there's some glue on the lens itself. So once you have replaced the lens, you might want to connect the Runcam Thumb Pro to your computer, as this can also be used as a webcam, and you can just make the focal adjustments there, making sure that everything is all nice and focused. And when that is done, we put that all back into the original case and we are ready to fly. Okay, so the mod for the Runcam Thumb has been done, and we'll see how it goes. So, hope you guys enjoyed this video. You check this out. Alright, so I've only found out about the Runcam Thumb TPU mount that my buddy Sujit printed for me. It's showing on the screen on post. So, I'm just gonna crop it just a tiny bit without sacrificing the field of view. We'll be right back. So there are pros and cons about this camera, and one of the things I love about it is the fact that it is very, very light. I think it's one of the lightest 4K camera there is around. So with the lens mod, you could only tell like on post-production. So most of the time, you can't really tell unless you review the footage that you got. So after trying out some of the lenses and testing them out and checking them back on the computer, I found that this one so far is the better one. Unfortunately, this lens is not readily available. This is the Cadex Turtle V2, and those lenses are really hard to find these days. But if you do have one, or if you do find them, you know, get them and do the lens mod for the Runcam Thumb Pro. Either that, or you could just get the Runcam Thumb Pro W. It's like a mouthful to say. Well, that's it for today's video. I hope you guys have a great week. So thank you all for watching, and see you guys again soon. Ciao.